Hi, my name is Molly Barringer. I'm the lead PI of the ARGO program here at AOML. The ARGO program is a global program where more than 3,000 of these active floats are deployed globally across the world. These floats are profiling instruments that give us temperature, pressure, salinity, sometimes oxygen, and we're trying to actually augment them with as many other kinds of instruments as we possibly can, like ABCD current measurements. AOML is partners in the ARGO program with Scripps, Woods Hole, PML, our sister lab at NOAA, University of Washington, and Fleet Numerical. AOML's role in the ARGO program is to do Atlantic deployments of ARGO floats and process and QC all of the U.S. deployed ARGO floats. That amounts to about 1,500 of the more than 3,000 floats that have been deployed worldwide, and that translates into about 10,000 profiles processed, QC, and sent for global distribution through our lab.
I'm Claudia Schmidt. I work for NOAA AOML in Miami. My main project is the ARGO project, and I'm a data manager in that project. And I'm also a scientist analyzing the ARGO data. So this is a schematic of how a float operates. It gets deployed from a ship or an airplane, and as soon as it realizes it's in the water, it sinks down to its target depth at 1,000 to 2,000 meters, drifts at that depth for about 10 days, and then takes a profile from its profiling depth back to the surface, and it measures pressure and temperature along the way and salinity, sometimes also oxygen or other parameters. Once it hits the surface, it transmits the data through a satellite system to the ground station, and from there it goes to the data center for decoding and quality control and data distribution. This is a schematic diagram of a float. At the top of the float are the sensors for the measurements and also an antenna. In the middle is the electronics that controls the float, and the lower part is the batteries and a pump that's used to change the buoyancy of the float by pumping oil into a bladder that's external to the float. For data transmission at the surface, to get the antenna farther out of the water, there is an extra external bladder here that is filled with air while the float is on the surface to transmit the data. This is a map of all the floats that are currently in the water in this international project. It shows a good global coverage with some exceptions in the Antarctic Ocean. There are new floats that can be deployed and operate under in ice zones, so the coverage is improving in the ice-covered oceans. The colors indicate the originating country, so the green ones are from the US, which is about half the away. This map shows all the US ARGO floats that had a profile within the last 12 days. This is an interactive map, so each of these dots here for float leads to a plot with the data from the float. This is an example of the data plots from one float that are accessible through the interactive map. This is a float that was deployed in the Pacific Ocean, close to the Drake Passage. It drifted eastward through the Drake Passage and continued east all the way almost to South Africa. This is the temperature profile that recorded throughout a period of 6 years. And these are the salinity plots for the same float.